I want to tell you that I don't see them so guilty like that you explain them. I know what's written in the Torah Kedoshah.
Right.
The Torah Kedoshah is saying that it's not allowed. Right. And that you need to kill the person that done that. But you know that it's written also on a person that breaks Shabbos, that violates Shabbos, that you need to kill him. Execute him. You ask your question.
Right.
That's what it's written. So are we really going to take a gun and start going and slaughtering people, shooting people? No. So we and we understand that it's not. Why not? Why not? ISIS are doing it.
Right.
We don't think that that's the will of Hashem. Right. Inside, even though that it is written in the Torah that if a person just violated Shabbos, he destroyed Shabbos, he lit the fire, he turned on his car and drove to the sea in Shabbos, the Torah is saying you need to kill him.
Right.
We don't believe that that is the real will of Hashem Yitbarach, even though that it's written in the Torah. We're going to put all of our effort to read between the lines and to understand what is the real intention, the real meaning of Hashem Yitbarach, right? So, now I'm going to tell you. First of all, I want to tell you that this is a question that even huge righteous people that I met with and that I spoke with, they didn't know the answer. They still don't know the answer on that.
The answer of what? Like
of why people are suffering so much and why people are coming to those places. Because it's a problem in their souls, in their nefesh, in their spirits. I know people that from age of 3, they already felt like they are in a wrong body. Right. Men that felt like women from age of 3. They feel like I'm a little girl that trapped in a boy's body. And you cannot kill a person like that. You cannot understand. You cannot judge him with the mindset of the Torah Kedoshah.
Right.
Shh. Listen. You ask a question, receive the answer. The situation is that when Hashem Yitbarach will reveal his mercy to the world, so he's going to heal the creation. And then the creation will not going to behave as it behaved today. There are a lot of things that are bent today, but you cannot straighten them up. If you're gonna try to straighten them up, you're gonna break them. If you're gonna take even our mindset of how we're serving Hashem Yitbarach and you're gonna try to put us into the Shulchan Aruch, like the Shulchan Aruch is saying, you're gonna kill us, you're gonna kill me. Me, take me, that I'm Haredi, that I keep Shabbat, and I'm eating kasher, and every day I'm waking up and as early as I can, and I'm putting tefillin, Rashi, Rabbeinu Tam, and everything I'm trying to do is the best. Is force me to keep the Shulchan Aruch, I'm going to die. I'm not able to do it today. It's not in my ability. For sure it's going to destroy my family, it's going to destroy my wife, my children. Our family is going to break to pieces. I'm not going to hold on. So, to take someone that even more bent than I, there are people that are even more bent than I, and take them into the Shulchan Aruch and try to, it means to cut them to pieces and to put those pieces inside the Shulchan Aruch. You cannot bring them into it. So, Hashem Yitbarach needs to reveal to us the Torah that is Atika Setima'a, that is ancient and is hidden from us. This is the white fire that is written under the black fire. This is Atika Setima'a, ancient. And it's impossible for us to understand. And when Hashem Yitbarach is going to explain to us the white space between the lines, then we're going to understand how to heal all of the souls and all of the spirits and all of the people and to guide them, to bring them into the right way. When HaKadosh Baruch Hu said that he will not going to bring the flood again, means that he will not going to destroy those people. He will not going to punish them as he punished them before. Because HaKadosh Baruch Hu, ve'itatzev elibo, he was sad. He was sad. He looked at the creation and he was sad. And after the destruction, after that he destroyed the world with the flood, so Noach, that he was the righteous man, the leader of that generation, he cried. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu told him, Raya, Shatya, you're a foolish leader. You're a fool. Now you're crying? After the flood you're crying? You were supposed to cry before of the flood. I gave you so many years to cry, to pray on the people that I'm not going to kill them. But you chose to save yourself, to build for yourself the ark, the teva, and to hide in your teva, and to hide over there, to save your family. You're a fool. You had so many years, and you didn't cry. Now you're crying on the destruction. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he's got that wisdom. He doesn't want to destroy the world. Because that Noach didn't have that wisdom, so the world been destroyed in the flood. But it wasn't the will of Hashem Yitbarach. And Hashem Yitbarach revealed His will and promised and made an oath. This is the rainbow, that we will not going to have a flood anymore. And why you think that they chose that rainbow for their flag? Why? Rainbow. And they're getting stronger. But what is the rainbow? To save us from what they're getting stronger in. So what it means, that there is a balance. It's getting stronger, but it's the rainbow.
Who told you that?
What's going on? There is a balance.
Wow.
Who is making the balance? Hashem Yitbarach. For us, it looks wild. Wow, it looks crazy. It looks sick. Wow, what's going on? 200,000. You know how many people came from out of Eretz Israel? In flight. They came in flights to Eretz Israel to support them, to protest with them. You can understand it. We cannot understand it. But we can understand if we have a heart. We will understand that it's not their fault. That we cannot blame them. You can say, I despise it, I don't want it, I don't want to need it close to my house, I don't want my children to see things. Okay, no problem. But to take that person now and to judge him on his actions, I tell you, you're 100% wrong. You don't understand. Don't understand.
Well, not to judge him, but I just feel bad. Because it's
okay,
like,
so feel bad. So if you feel bad,
Hashem.
Okay, so you say that it's so against Hashem. The Torah is saying it's so against Hashem. And I'm telling you that this person, I'm not supporting it, achi. But I will tell you that I heard a woman that she said, like that person that I told you, a man in a physical, in a woman in the body of a man. That's how he feels from age of 3. When he was 14 and he came, it's a person that I know. He came to his father when he was 14 and he told him, Father, I am gay. His father told him, we know it from you when you were 3, when you were 4. It's so okay, yeah. I'm happy it's obvious. He told him, Father, how did you know? He said, I was buying you trucks and you wouldn't play with them. And you would sit and you look at the magazines of your mother and you would play with Barbie dolls from the age of 3. Age of 3, that was he was a kid. It wasn't adultery, it wasn't nothing. He was just, he liked dresses, he liked women, he liked dolls, he liked to play with dolls. That's what he liked. A woman that was married, I heard her talking. She said, I was married, she's a mother to 3. She said, I couldn't stand my life with my husband. And I'm sorry to tell you, I was straight, everything was great. Today she's a lesbian. And she's saying, I don't know what to say. I don't know how to explain, but I'm telling you that the love that I have to this woman is something that I never felt in my life. And I was miserable in my marriage, and I suffered, and I hated my life. And today I love her, and she loves me, and they just live their lives together. And you want to say, and you have an opinion, I'm not saying you, people, Haredi, they have what to say. Great, okay, I understand you. It's written in the Torah. You're right. Always you're right. You're always right. Women are always right. You're always right. You're right. Women are always right. You're right. Charedim, you're always right. You're like women. You're always right. Always justifying yourself. Always need to bow to you, to tell you you're right. You're right. Yes, for sure. You're a rabbi, for sure. Yes. Of course, whatever you say. Amen. Kiss your hands. Nonsense. Open your eyes. Reality. It can be your child. What are you going to do? Sit Shiva on him? Not going to talk to him anymore? Okay, do it. You're right. Everything is right. You know how many gays coming out from the Haredi communities? You know how many gays coming out from the yeshivot? You know how many gays are coming from yeshivot bachurim? You know how many lesbians are coming from midrashot? You're going to hear stories, your ears will fall from your face. You will drill into your brain.
Oh, yeah, I remember it's Rav Arush.
Okay.
No, he said that we're in the Sphira.
Rav Arush told me He told me, I don't understand what's going on in the world with this thing. I need to do a long 6 hours itbodedut on it to understand what's going on. Because Rav Shalom told me, I was talking to people like those and I couldn't explain them. I couldn't reach them. You talk to that person and you cannot explain to him his mistake. You know why you cannot explain to him his mistake? Because you don't understand his mistake. If you would get his mistake, you would explain to him his mistake. If you know that that person is doing something wrong, you can reach out to him. You can explain it to him. If you have that experience,
right,
you need to have people from inside that are going to do tshuva, what it means. That Hashem Yitbarach needs to bring down the mercy, the rachamim, into those dark places, into those rainbow places, and to wake people up from those places. And when they're going to do tshuva, they will have the power to go and to talk over there and to explain how they came out from it and how they saw the light and how that Hashem Yitbarach can heal you even from such a messed up situations and lust that looks like love and bent things that look so straight and okay. Oy la omrim al matok mar ve la mar matok. We're saying, oh, we're crying on those people that feel that bitterness is sweet for them and sweetness is bitter for them. Okay, we're crying. Oy, we're saying, oy. Thank you, Chazak.